The government's new health reform plans could be looking a little under the weather, with a final agreement now looking some way off. For more, we're joined by our political reporter in Canberra, Leah Craven. Good morning, Leah. Exactly what are the stumbling blocks that have to be overcome before this is implemented?
Well, Tash, even though premiers have signed on the bottom line, it is only an in-principle agreement. The deal won't be finalised until the Prime Minister meets with the premiers at the next COAG meeting, which is in the middle of the year. In the meantime, all of the finer details need to be nutted out, such as how the price of individual medical procedures will be set. And there are a few stumbling blocks, the biggest probably being the New South Wales state election. Barry O'Farrell's the man who's most likely to be the Premier of New South Wales come next month, and he's probably going to bring a few more demands to the negotiating table. He's concerned that the national pricing system could leave New South Wales out of pocket, so he's giving no guarantees he'll sign up. And of course, the fate of the package also depends on the hung parliament federally. The opposition, even though the federal Liberal premiers have signed up to this deal, the federal Liberal Party are saying they're not going to necessarily guarantee the passage of this through Parliament. But there is one win for the government. The former Prime Minister Kevin Rudd has finally thrown his support behind this deal. Now, there were reports that he stormed out of a cabinet meeting when he learnt that the cornerstone of his package, which was that the government would no longer be the dominant funder, but he said that it just isn't true.
Ali, I don't intend to contribute to this debate one bit. The key thing is that we have a major national health reform, which the Prime Minister succeeded in concluding with the state premiers.
So at least the government can now present a united front, Tash.
But Leah, with all this contention, and gosh, this has been such a long process, realistically, are we likely to see any major changes to health this year?
Well, Tash, that depends who you ask. If you ask the federal opposition, they say that we won't be seeing any changes for a decade. And of course, we won't be seeing any changes overnight. This is a long-term reform plan. The Health Minister, Nicola Roxon, says that we will start to see some changes come July 1, though. $200 million will be injected into the hospital system if the states meet some of the benchmarks set by the federal government. Now, one of these is a maximum four-hour wait in emergency waiting rooms. Tash?
Leah Craven in Canberra, thanks so much.